What do people mean when they say I froze to describe not fighting or escaping from a sexual assault? The meaning may seem obvious because freeze conveys what wasn't done. They might be referring to any lack of resistance during a sexual assault. But scientifically and neurobiologically, freeze has particular meanings. In fact, we can distinguish three types of freezing: detection freezing, shocked freezing, and no good choices freezing. If we understand those three types, then we'll better understand why and how people often don't resist or escape at the beginning of sexual assaults. But first, some background. When we are in danger or highly stressed, the brain shifts behavior to reflexes and habits. Freezing responses are reflexes. That means they've been hardwired into our brains by evolution. And they're survival reflexes, which means freezing enabled our ancestors to survive dangerous experiences, especially with large predators that wanted to eat them. In a nutshell, freezing reflexes make us stop everything, receive information about the danger or attack, and wait for our brains to cue up potential responses. The first type of freezing is detection freezing. It happens at the beginning of many sexual assaults, when the brain's defense circuitry detects that a normal and expected situation, kissing a date, talking with a boss, watching a movie with a friend, has suddenly escalated to something unwanted. Or when the other person doesn't stop doing something sexual, despite clear signals it's unwelcome. It's the moment when an attack is detected. Later, looking back on that moment of detection freezing, people often say, "I froze for a second." The potential triggers of detection freezing are limitless, but the response is basically the same. Instantly and involuntarily, sometimes with a jolt, everything stops. All movement instantly stops. Thinking stops. It's a kind of network reset, so the brain can receive new information and potentially generate responses. Soldiers and police experience detection freezing too, especially when their brains first recognize they're being attacked. Evolution has put this reflex response into everyone's brain. The second potential freeze response is shocked freezing. It's when that initial stopping of all movement and thinking lasts longer than a couple of seconds. Trying to describe their experience of shocked freezing, people say things like, "I was in shock," or "my mind went blank." It's a stunning and memorable experience. It's being stuck in that network reset. For several seconds, a person may be dumbfounded, completely at a loss for words and actions. Looking back, people say things like, "I couldn't even think," and "I had no idea what to do." The brain is literally not generating any behavior options to choose from. It's a helpless and horrifying experience, especially when unwanted and disturbing sexual things are being done to one's body, and it's called shocked freezing. The third type of freezing is no good choices freezing. To understand no good choices freezing, we must know this. When the brain's defense circuitry detects an attack, it quickly impairs the prefrontal cortex. That's the rational part of the brain, and the defense circuitry impairs it because, compared to reflexes and habits, reasoning is much too slow. That's why many sexual assault survivors recall how suddenly their thinking was severely limited. That's why the first thoughts to pop up tend to be very simple ones, and they're often thoughts about extreme behaviors queued up by the defense circuitry. Someone may remember, "All I could think was," and complete that sentence with a thought or two that, later with the rational brain back online, seem remarkably simple, even useless or ridiculous. Some recall being stuck between two completely opposite responses, one extremely reactive and the other totally passive. People assaulted while being massaged, for example, have said, "All I could think was jump off the table and run down the hall naked yelling for help, or just lie there and wait for them to stop." During no good choices freezing, more rational and potentially effective thoughts and behaviors don't even arise as options in the brain or mind. Basically, right after detection or shocked freezing, thinking can be reduced to extreme lose-lose options, to choices that are no real choices at all. That's why it's called no good choices freezing. and people can get stuck there for seconds, even minutes. We hope it's been helpful to learn about these three different types of freezing. Another video will explain the extreme survival reflexes of tonic immobility and collapsed immobility that tend to happen later in sexual assaults, in which people are not just frozen, but literally paralyzed. Finally, while people may refer to many experiences as being frozen, scientific concepts of freezing, as explained in this video, help to clarify the reflex responses that can happen at different phases of sexual assaults.